Hello, so today I want to show you how to test your batteries on your X or S model electric ATV. Sometimes you have a problem that you're turning on the ignition switch and you have lights on your throttle handle. Right now this one is not connected, so I'm just showing an example. So you will have all lights. When you twist the throttle, they will be disappearing all the way to the bottom, and when you release it, it will go up again and the machine is not moving. So you automatically think that, well, this is showing the battery level, so the battery should be okay. Sometimes it's showing, yes, it's okay, but not always. So of course would be the first thing to check would be to take a voltmeter and to test your battery plug. So how many volts coming out? So in this case 39 volts, which is pretty good. That's what you need, because each battery have 12 volts, or 12 24, and then another 12 36. You have 39 because when it's fully charged it will be showing like it has more than 12 volts. It's going to show 12.8 or 12.9, for example. I'm going to test each battery individually. 12.9 and then 12.9 and then 12.9. So each battery has almost one extra volt when it's fully charged, so it's pretty normal. So this is not the problem, right? You might think, well, why is my machine is not moving and why is my charger is not switching to the red charging mode when I'm plugging my charger? So your charger is actually a smart charger. It's going to indicate and is going to detect one of the battery problems right away before even you're going to take a voltmeter. But before you're going to come to the conclusion that you have one of the batteries are faulty, you have to test if your charger is working. So on a round plug, you have a pin number marked with number 1 and number 3. This is what you want to test it. So here you go. We have 41 volts. So voltage is coming out from the charger. And I have a charging port. I'm going to connect it just directly, black to black and red to red. Okay, and I'm going to switch it to the plug, and the light's still green. It's not switching to the red charging mode. Why? Everything is connected, batteries are good. What's the problem? So you might think, well, it's fully charged, so it's not going to switch it to the red charging mode because it doesn't need any voltage. Well, it's not true. This charger supposed to switch to a red charging mode no matter what, just to see how much power or how much charging time it needed to finish, to top it off. But in this case it never switched to the red charging mode because it detected that one of the batteries has problems. So let's see if it's going to show. You remember that before that we had 39 volts coming out, and let's see what we're going to have with a plugged-in charger. We have the same voltage as coming out from the charger round socket, 41 volts. So the batteries are actually looks like it's accepting charge. So what's the problem? It's not switching to the red and the ATV is not moving. So most of the people, they automatically think that it's a controller needs to be replaced because the machine is not moving. Everything is properly working fine. Charger is working, battery are fully charged. Well, I was thinking the same way, but it's pretty to test your batteries with the voltmeter, just a voltmeter. It's pretty deceiving sometimes because voltmeter cannot detect faulty battery. Even if you will remove one of the wires like here and test just one battery, look, it's going to show you 12.9. Oh, hold on, Just change to the settings. 12.9 on the DC voltage. So even if I remove the one wire, and I'm going to use this bolt for the future testing, but look, we have 12.9 with that wire on and off. We have the next one, 12.9, and the next one, 12.9. So the batteries are excellent. So what's the problem? Well, don't come to the conclusion that this is the controller that you need right away before you test those batteries with a special tester, which is called a load tester, battery load tester. So I have one. This is pretty expensive one, but it's working really well. And I'm going to show you if this is the problem or not. So let's see, I'm going to test on the battery number 3. Okay, so I have a 13 volts, same voltage as my voltmeter showed. And then I'm going to press enter, which is a SLA battery. And then I'm going to set capacity, which is a 12 amp. So, and press enter. And it tested and it says good, pass, no problem at all. So this tester recognized this battery, no problem at all. Now next one, battery number 2. Battery voltage 12.9, same as the voltmeter showed before. SLA, which is our battery, and 12 amp, which is our amperage of our battery. And I push enter, so it's saying good and pass. So number 2 batteries is fine. And let's see what's going to happen with the battery number 3. Okay, so battery volts, it's showing somehow 8.4. Why is it showing less than my voltmeter? Well, because it's already sending some load while we're doing this test. So I'm pushing enter one more time, 12 amp, and push enter one more time. And it's testing and it's going to say bad cell. So this number 3 battery is no good. Even though that voltage might show that it's showing 12 volts without any load, but when you apply some load by twisting the throttle, it's going through the controller taking so much juice out of the battery, and the controller wants to send so many volts, so much power to the motor, that it's not enough, because these 2 volts that missing from this battery number 3, it's not visible for the regular voltmeter. As you see, it's showing like it has 12.9, but it's without the load. So of course, not everyone is going to buy this expensive tool, because it's like $250-$300 at the tester. But you can always take those batteries to your local battery places, whoever sell batteries, like Interstate Batteries or Batteries Plus company, or any whoever sell batteries, and they will test each battery individually, just like I did, to see which one is actually faulty, because voltmeter will not show you. It's pretty deceiving situation. So it's not always the charger the problem, it's not always the controller the problem. It could be hidden, invisible problem with your battery, and you don't see it with a regular basic voltmeter test. Okay, so I hope it's really clear for you. And once this battery is going to be replaced, your charger will switch to the red charging mode again. I will show you later when I will replace this one. I don't have a good battery right now, but this is the problem. I have a one faulty battery, and your machine will not move, or it will move, but it will be really, really slow once you lift up the rear end. So that would be your sign that no power to push on a high speed or higher speed, and your charger will detect it first. Thank you. Bye.